and charity to one another. Help us, we digress, to do only things that we think of while you bring me to us through your ministry, promising that, you know, at the budget hearing, you are going to give us more details about your mandate, about your the operations of your ministry. So I won't take much time. We are in the budget session now, so you give us a rundown on your appraisal of probably 2019 budget performance, and then, you know, our 2020 projection. So, Honorable Minister, over to you.
Of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development was created to strengthen coordination of humanitarian and disaster management efforts of multiple stakeholders and to ensure full institutionalization of federal government's social interventions. The ministry has the enormous responsibility of addressing some of the underlying causes, drivers, and or consequences of humanitarian crisis and underdevelopment, which includes relatively high poverty. Nearly half of the country's population live in extreme poverty. B, relatively high unemployment at 23.2%, with over 40 million unemployed or underemployed people. Then high number of persons of concern, including 2 million IDPs or thereabout, 230,000 Nigerian refugees living in Niger, Chad, and Cameroon, and 45,000 refugees living in our own domain, and over 22 million persons with disabilities, over 14 million persons in one form of drug and substance abuse or the other. F, growing needs of the elderly and other vulnerable groups. So, Mr. Chairman, distinguished members of the committee, the ministry has the following agencies under its purview, going by what I've just highlighted above. We have the National Commission for Refugees, Migrants, and Internally Displaced Persons. We have the National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA. We have the Northeast Development Commission. We have the NAPTIP, which is a national agency for the prohibition of traffic in persons. We have the Sustainable Development Goals. We also have two departments from the Ministry of Human Affairs, the Department of Social Welfare, and the Department of Rehabilitation for persons with disabilities. So these are the agencies and departments of government that fall within the purview of the newly created ministry. The proposed 2020 budget of the ministry was put together with the aim of meeting the growing needs of the most vulnerable in Nigeria and populations affected by disaster. Let me.
Yes, 2019,
sir. You know, it's a new ministry, so we expected that the agencies under the ministry should have come with us, so that they will give a rundown of what they have done thus far in 2019, if there's any. But for us, we have just taken off as the modern ministry, and we have not released even any funds for takeoff. So let me just go through the 2020 proposal, and then since I think NEMA is here, they can now make their own presentation. So the ministry's proposed budget is consistent with the economic recovery and growth plan, with the priority of investing in our people towards actualizing the next level aspiration of lifting 100 million Nigerians out of poverty in 10 years. This is also in line with the legislative agenda of the Ninth Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, which puts people first and focuses on improving the standard living of the generality of Nigerians. Implementation of the proposed budget is expected to strengthen Nigeria's social support systems and to contribute to the realization of sustainable development goals. As I mentioned earlier, we have six agencies under our purview. The proposed budget of the ministry has captured in the 2020 appropriation bill covers expenditure of the ministry headquarters and the six agencies under its supervision. Budget performance, the ministry headquarters and NEDC, as I mentioned, were recently created. There was therefore no allocation for the ministry and the commission in 2019. But the summary of performance of 2019 budgets of NCFRMI, National Commission for Refugees, Migrants and IDPs, the National Emergency Management Agency, the National Action and Prohibition of Traffic in Persons, NAPTIP, the Office of Senior Special Assistant to the President on SDGs, and the National Social Investment Office are presented in Table 1 below, which the chief executives can be allowed to provide more details. We have the personnel for the NCFRMI, which is appropriated at 374,978,612 naira, and the release was 330,507,691 naira for 84 kobo. They have so far utilized the whole of that amount released. For overhead, they have an appropriated sum of 55,155,336 naira, and they got a release of 27,557,667.98 naira kobo thus far released, and they have also utilized all the amount released. The total for the for capital, appropriated capital in 2019 for the commission is put to 3,919,499,960 naira. No release has been made thus far on the capital appropriated, and therefore no amount was utilized. It goes in that order. For NEMA, we have an appropriated personnel cost of 847,564,925 naira. The release was put to 602,446,779.01 naira, and they have been able to utilize 599,262,331 naira. Like that, in that order. For NEMA, they have a capital appropriation of 444,834,921 naira.
Honorable Minister, let me spare you.
Yes.
We'll be talking strictly about your own ministry, because I know that the chief executives of other agencies will take them up on one or two discussions. I think it is very laudable that today this ministry is created in Nigeria. I think it has been long overdue. But Mr. President, in his wisdom, have decided that this is the time to form this ministry so that to coordinate all these issues that are taking place in the land. I am from the Northeast. I represent the very place that was carved out of Nigeria by the insurgents and declared it as their own caliphate. That is Adamawa North. In fact, my local government movie was renamed to Madinatul Islam from movie local government. They renamed my local government when Boko Haram invaded the area. In fact, one of my houses was made to be the house of the Amir. He was living in my house, sleeping on my bed. So we know what our people are going through. I am worried, very, very worried. Presidential initiative for the Northeast came up. Not much was achieved. Even though there was an assessment that was made, works, infrastructure, housing, and other different departments, assessment was made. Buhari plan came up. They did another assessment. Now, all these assessments, they are lying down there. Now, the Northeast Development Commission was formed, which now will be under your ministry. I was worried some time ago, even though it was not official, it was my engagement with the commission, that they won't embark on another assessment. Now, maybe take us another 1 year doing assessment. While there was assessment before, there was another assessment. We are spending years doing assessments, and my people are still in charge. My people are still living in semi-detention facilities in Cameroon. They are there as refugees, but they are actually surrounded by Cameroonian gendarmes. They are not allowed to move out of the IDP camp. They are prisoners in Cameroon. Nobody is thinking of bringing them back, resettling them, rebuilding these communities. So I am appealing here, while I agree with my colleague here and my elder brother, he is from Gaza. I am from Mubi. While
Honorable Minister, while expanding your comments, you just restrict us to the budget so that we can.
Yeah. While actually I am of the opinion that your budget is too small. It is too small. And it is just a drop. If we are serious about managing disasters, humanitarian crisis in this country, this budget needs to be increased. And also, we have to go into implementation of those assessments and not do another assessment. Finally, ma'am, distinguished, this is my only time to talk. So we cannot just talk about figures. We have 22 million persons living with disability. I think, Honorable Minister, it is high time to give people living with disability their commission. 22 million people. There's nothing wrong if we create a commission for people living with disabilities. I think their voice will be heard more. And I believe with somebody like you that I read about a lot, I think he will support this so that people living with disability will have their own commission. Thank you, Honorable Minister. Thank you, my chairman.
How long we pray? It happens often. The one that happened in Onitsha, you did not budget for it. You were there. I don't know what is happening again now. You were in Maiduguri. You have seen the extent of damage. This budget, both NEMA and you, is it an anticipation of what is happening, what is on ground already? The disaster that we are experiencing already. Or another one. Well, if it is the one we are experiencing, and from I've been in that part of the world and I went there of recent. I don't know whether the capital allocation there, this one, will be part of the reconstruction and rehabilitation of the damaged properties and roads and bridges, or what even if it's some ordinary refugees, more refugees are even coming from either Libya, Egypt, Cameroon. For now, Cameroon is fighting southern Cameroon, where we have a lot of our people, the Nigerians there. Mr. Minister, when you budget on what is on ground, then you anticipate in case. Well, it will be very difficult for Mr. President to dip his hand on money that is not there. We have to anticipate on what is coming, because a problem leads to another. Boko Haram has led to many things now. Virtually everywhere you have almost disaster. The fallout of one insurgent is leading to others. Me, I will say this particular budget is rather too low for your ministry to cope with the problem we are facing. The other time you were mentioning 45,000 refugees in different localities providing durable solutions. IDB in Bakassi alone, they are going to almost 10,000. The ones we have in the north is another problem. The ones we are having in-house that they don't even talk, you have not identified, there are very many. Everywhere is almost refugee camp. See what is happening in Kaduna. You are now bringing out another refugee which needs to be rehabilitated by your ministry. Better than that, Kaduna or not, it is part of rehabilitation. I will support a situation where your budget will be realistic. Not every day you will be calling on NEMA. NEMA, go to this. NEMA, go to that place. The budget, the fund must be there. So as to quench this particular problem. And don't forget, the youth that are out of school, you have mentioned, is it 20 million? They are more than that too. Then the drug addict, in Kano alone, I don't know how many. The war that broke out, the internal war that we are experiencing in those three states in the north, has displaced a lot of people. If not the effort of the governors there that they are just building schools. And the way, the more they are building, the more these people come around and see this way. So, whatever we are going to do, even on publicity, I have never seen any budget on publicity, because we need a lot of publicity, enlightenment within those zones. With this little contribution, I will employ our committee to look into this problem personally. Because we don't have security, we don't have any security outfit. If Borono is not okay, Adamawa is not okay, Yobe, part of all Nigerians will not be okay. Let us budget very well for this. And since I come from that side, my people are so many there. And there's nowhere they will come here. But there's no space. So what we keep them there, let us budget and support the increase in their budget. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Of my colleagues in advocating for an overall review of the budget within the window allowed by the Senate, maybe the 5% window, if needs be, for us to jack it up. Honorable Minister, you are a square peg in a square hole. Since you cut your teeth in the National Commission for Refugees, it's more expensive to rent a house in Maiduguri than in Abuja. The NGOs, it's more expensive than Lagos, because the NGOs have succeeded in dollarizing the local economy so that people are renting out their homes and coming to Gozape or Golimpa and rent houses. And it doesn't augur well for the system. I want to make it clear, the UN agencies are doing a good job. But there are lots of NGOs that are smiling their way to the bank on the agony of our people. I will urge you, Honorable Minister, to partner with the Ministry of Finance and Budget and Planning to see that those issues of the NGOs are addressed quietly. Some are of dubious origin, carrying out dubious activities. Their activities need to be curtailed. I'm not talking about the UN. Some of the UN agencies are doing very great jobs. Secondly, it has to do with the resettlement of our people. The former, the defunct presidential initiative in the Northeast, they went and bought water cabins for classrooms in an environment that is nastily uncomfortable. In Maiduguri, the temperature goes to as high as 45 degrees during the off-season. They went and bought water cabins for classrooms at the IDP camp at a cost of 16 million naira per unit. And if you give me 16 million, I can build you 4 classrooms. So I will ask you, Honorable Minister, to ensure that permanent structures are erected under the organizations which are under the purview of your ministry. Permanent structures, and most importantly, Honorable Minister, there is donor fatigue, and the issue of entitlement syndrome has started cropping up. Visit any of the IDP camps. There is a very thriving, very active industry on child prostitution, on early child marriages, on drugs abuse. A lot of antisocial activities are going on in those IDP camps. The best thing is, for the people of Gaza, for the people of Damascus, for the people of Mubi, let them be relocated back to their home state, especially the local government headquarters, which are better secured, and be provided with means of livelihood so that they can carry their poverty with dignity. A situation whereby people are made to be catered for. And this thing will not continue ad infinitum. The largest IDP camp in the world is the Dadaab refugee camp in Kenya. The Kenyan government finally summoned the political willpower to close those IDP camps. Under your tutelage, I am beseeching you, I am begging you in the name of God, to see that this madness of the IDP camps are brought to an end. Build permanent structures. Don't subscribe to the idea of tents. Tents is not ideal for our environment in the Northeast. And the cost of a single tent can build a house. So it doesn't make sense for us to spend billions of naira erecting tents that might not last for more than 6 months or a year. So these are my contributions. I wish you well.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Start with the submission or the comment made by distinguished Senator Alun Jumo. Okay, let me start with His Excellency, distinguished Senator Shetima. Yes, we're all in this work together, distinguished Senator, while you were the governor of Borno State. And I have always been an advocate of exiting from emergency. We cannot continue to be in emergency forever. We must have a plan whereby we exit. It has to be in phases, and it is long overdue. So I have that as one of my main focus as a minister of this ministry, that we must begin to see how we can resettle these people back to their societies in safety and in dignity. Those areas where it is safe for them to return, they have to return, and we're going to support them with the livelihoods support. I had a very extensive discussion with the governor of Borno State yesterday. I also discussed with the MD, Northeast Development Commission, and I told him that, look, we cannot continue to be giving these people food. It's just not sustainable. NEMA is doing its best. The resources is very, lean, and that's why we don't seem to see the impact, because you keep giving somebody the food, you continue to give him food forever, but you have to support that person to be able to take care of himself, and we're going to work together with all partners to see that these people are resettled. We give them these durable solutions of resettlement, rehabilitating them, and then empowering them so that they can be on their own. I'm happy that you mentioned some locations, because you know these areas. Gaza, for one, we've gone to Gaza together with you. And we have seen people in Gaza. So those here that are saying they're from Gaza, as you rightly mentioned that time, they're economic migrants, really, economic IDPs. So we're going to focus on that, Your Excellency, if we have to. No, sir, you are a legislator in Abuja representing the good people of your constituency. So Your Excellency, distinguished Chairman, we were going to work on that with all the relevant agencies to see that we're able to achieve that. And the comments made on the INGOs, yes, I agree with you. Yesterday is one of such issues that we want to resolve in Maiduguri. The UN Undersecretary on Humanitarian Affairs and Relief Coordinator is still around. We visited Maiduguri and we had a meeting with the Chacha commander. We have to, you know, change the narrative. We have to come together and see how we can work together with our limitations and the rules of engagement. We must take care of that, distinguished chairman. Permanent structures, yes. No more. This camp, erecting, you know, tents in camp and making them look like we are giving these people shelter, it's just not it. That is not shelter. That is not adequate shelter. People are in camp. When it is time for them to leave camp, they have to leave camp. And we are talking together with His Excellency. I think he also has that as part of his plans to start closing up camps, especially in Maiduguri, where we have many of them. The distinguished senator from Oshiri, you made mention of disasters happening, unforeseen circumstances. Yes, we have those ones that are supposed to be taking care of those issues now on disasters, and we have the ones that might come in future. And well, NEMA is here, and he's going to talk on that, what they've been doing. I'm sure they have a provision for the unforeseen disasters when they happen. I'm yet to receive briefing from NEMA. I think we are to meet tomorrow, so he's here, he can elaborate on that, how they take care of the unforeseen disasters that come. Yes, we have many refugees, as you rightly mentioned. We have those ones in our country. We have our own that are in other countries. Distinguished senator from Adamawa North, yes, we have refugees in Cameroon. You may recall that I was in Cameroon just 2 months ago to start repatriating these refugees back home. They are in a camp called Minawawo Camp. And honestly, they are living a normal life. I feasted there. They are not under any security threat. Yes, it's not good to be in that kind of situation, but we have given them the option. This repatriation is voluntary. People choose to come back, we bring them back. But those that want to stay, we had very extensive discussions with the governor of Adamawa State. We're bringing back people from Adamawa. By the time we wanted to start the exercise, people started withdrawing. We were supposed to bring back about 4,000, but we ended up bringing back just 200 plus. Most of those that indicated interest are those from Borno, and we're still waiting for Borno State government to give us the indication that they are ready to receive them. Then we start repatriating them back. But for Adamawa, we're only able to bring 200 plus. And this tripartite agreement is based on voluntary repatriation. So it's when they decide they want to come back that we bring them back. But Adamawa State has expressed willingness and readiness to receive their indigenous back home. Yes, NEDC, Senator Agbo again, yeah. I'm in discussions with the MD of the NEDC. We are not going to continue the way it used to be. I've mentioned it, and I think he's in agreement with that. We have to start focusing on recovery. On recovery, you know, not just this petty or very, very things that we do. So we hope that with the support of this distinguished committee, we'll be able to achieve on these priorities. Yes, humanitarian services is a huge thing, and it is something that affects our people. So that is why in my statement, I made mention of what we presented as our own budget presentation to the Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning. We're not obliged, so they only gave us that this is what we have. But that is why we're here, a distinguished chairman, distinguished senator, so that you can support us to see how this budget can be built up, so that we will do our work without much hindrance. I think I have. So we are on the same page in that regard. We want the budget to be reviewed, and we are happy that the distinguished committee is in agreement that this budget is grossly inadequate. So
people with really disability?
Yeah?
People with disability?
Yes, okay. The issue of the persons with disabilities, yes, you know, the single senator, the act has been passed, and this commission is in the pipeline, and I assure you that together with you, we are going to work to see that we have that commission in place. 15 million, was it 22 million people living with disabilities is quite a huge number, and they really deserve, they deserve to have a commission. So it is in our agenda that we're very distinguished senators.
Thank you, Honorable Minister. Before I make my comments, I don't know whether...
I'm sorry, we're the most seats in terms of Boko Haram insurgency in that part of the council. Borno is most seat, Yobe is second, and Adamawa is mildly hit.
When you had insurgents sleeping on his bed.
Despite that, we need to do more in order to contain displaced persons
to settle down properly. And I am of the support that your budget is increased so that you will be able to meet up some of your statutory obligations. All what has been said by distinguished Senator Dume, I am in total support of that. Inshallah, during our legislative discussions on your budgets, we shall give you all the necessary support to ensure that you discharge your responsibilities successfully during your own time and even thereafter. Inshallah, we are in support. You are welcome.
The last time we met, you promised to avail us with a copy of the mandate so that we know exactly the parastatals, you know, under you, and also the level of mandate given to you. It is very, very important for our coordination with other sister committees. Just from your right up here, we know we are talking about the Refugee Commission, NEMA, NAPTIP. Basically, that is under us here. The others are under poverty alleviation. So by my understanding, you are going to meet tomorrow to have full briefing from NEMA. So we will run down his own budget today, and then we will not wait for your own discussion before we run his budget. Also, you know, in funding, I know there are so many donations that are coming, although there is fatigue now. Now, how do you, these are in respect of humanitarian, in respect of disaster, in respect of, others, how do you normally collect those ones? How do they come to you? They come to Minister of Finance and then, pass to you, or who has the record of those donations that come in respect of humanitarian and disaster management in this country? Second to that question is, when it comes to funding of your operations, there are some projects that are funded by donors and there are some projects that are funded by the Treasury. So I think we need to have, a clear demarcation between which is funded by donors and which are funded by the Treasury. It is very, very important. Well, the issue of NGOs has come up. It will continue to come up until we decide to do the right thing. And the right thing here is that every NGO that is part and parcel of humanitarian and disaster management, even insurgency, we need to have their own full records, their own who registered them, who are the people behind them. These are very, very fundamental, so that we can know how we can tackle, you know, them in terms of their performance, in terms of their activities. Performance, we know some of them, you know, come with just in kind and not in cash. So they will say cash, but the kind is more than the cash, and we may not be able to get the kind of benefit we should get. So we need to have assessment of our NGOs in respect of humanitarian and disaster management in this country and their own impact. Yes, assessments is very, very important. I don't think we have luxury of time and luxury of resources to go ahead and be doing a lot of assessments again, you know, before we help, you know, people in terms of humanitarian and also disaster. So there are so many studies that were done, so many assessments have been done, so I don't think we should go back to that to explain the little resources that we have on consultancies. Unless if there are some areas, few areas for amendments, yes, that can be done. Yes, increase in budget, it is important. The committee will sit down and look at it and discuss it with the leadership, you know, of the Senate, and see areas in which, you know, we can have, you know, inroad into this to have more for budget on humanitarian and disaster. But those budgets will basically go for developmental, I think, rather than, you know, humanitarian. That is more of developmental than humanitarian. Because humanitarian is just consumption, just like what you have said. You know, so much money is pumped, but, you know, no visible development is, so that we can quickly as possible, you know, exit, you know, this IDP issue. In terms of refugees, in Taraba we have a dual traffic. We have Nigerians in Cameroon and we have Cameroonians in Nigeria. And I think there are some in Cross River as well. So, you know, tackling it from two ends, I think will require a lot of, you know, tenacity. In my local government, Sardana local government, Taraba State, this Ambazonia, you know, is becoming a very, very big headache for us. It's creating so much insecurity for our people. So maybe you need to look at that. We will work together on that and then see the issues of Amazonia. Following that, I want to refer you to page 3 of your proposal or your presentation. You have seen the page?
Yes.
Now I'm referring to NAPTIP. If you look at the appropriation for personnel of NAPTIP, is 1.6 billion, and the appropriation for NEMA is 847 million. But even personnel for which one again? Okay. So, and then you can look at the releases. Unless if it is an error, I shouldn't think that, you know, NAPTIP will have more staff than NEMA. So I think either it is an error or there is an assumption which we are yet to find. So probably your ministry, you know, we will have a special meeting between us and NAPTIP so that we know exactly, you know, what is the cause of this. Because the amount released to them for personnel is 970 million. While that of NEMA is just 602 million. So I think probably there's an issue here which we need to sort it out. So, well, Honorable Minister, on this note, I want to see if there are some responses you can make on some of the comments that we have made. But finally, before you make your comments, I meant to understand that you are trying to take off effectively. And on our part here, we can assure you, you know, all the agencies that are supposed to be under you will make sure they work together with us and you in harmony so that we can achieve whatever is required, you know, for the humanitarian disaster management and social development. Because your ministry is so important that, you know, you have been oversight by more than one committee of the, the National Assembly, maybe four or five committees. So you can see how important your ministry is, and also the parastatals, because most of them are intervention. So we hope you look seriously into that and we work together, and we might sit down also between us, you, and the parastatals under you, so that we can put our heads together and fashion a new level of progress for this country. So you can go ahead and make your final comments. Thank you. Thank you.
Done that successfully. The committee is happy with our presentation. We are happy with their own comments. And we hope for a very good working relationship with the committee.
Notably, the lawmakers are advocating for an increase in the budget, considering the amount of intervention, the extent of work being done. What are your thoughts on it?
Of course, like Oliver Twist, we always ask for more, and you have just said it. It's quite a very huge ministry with huge responsibilities of interventions to our citizens, the most vulnerable in the society, people that need our assistance and support. So we need more money, and we hope that the National Assembly, through the committee, will support us in delivering to our mandate. Thank you very much.
Are you worried with the rate of disaster in our country, especially as it relates to flood and humanitarian?
Of course. As a human being, first and foremost, I'm worried. As a Nigerian, I'm worried. As a minister, saddled with the affairs of this ministry, I am more worried. So we're going to look at all these issues and see how we can prevent some of these disasters happening, or how we can respond more effectively when they happen. Thank you very much.